watching AMD Garage. This is Eric. This is a 62 C60 truck, and what you're seeing has never been born from General Motors, but this thing really caught our eye, man. So thank you for taking the time and talking to us about it.
It's always an honor and a pleasure.
Yeah, so give the people watching a little bit of an overview of what it is and how it got started.
So we found this out in West Kansas. It had been a single family truck. They had picked it up when it was brand new out on the farm.
Yeah.
It started out life as a 1962 Chevy 60 grain truck, had a big dump bed on the back of it.
Yeah.
I went out a little over 2 years ago and picked it up. They were finally selling it. And as soon as we got it back, we put it on we had a dark donor truck. It was a 1995 Chevy 2500.
Yeah.
And we took the donor truck off, mounted that up on it.
Yeah.
Well, it's a C60-C10 because it's a C10 fleet side.
Yeah.
Long bed, and then we've got the C10 step side fenders.
Right, and grafted in nicely and proportional too.
Thank you,
so yeah, it catches you. So with the 2500 series chassis, you've got all the heavy duty running gear. So it's as beefy as it looks, right?
As far as the chassis goes, yes.
Yeah.
Now the problem that we ran into was we changed the fulcrum point because the truck itself, from outside to outside,
yeah,
is 8'2".
Yeah.
So we had to really bring the front tires out almost 9 inches to get it to go. So
wow, okay.
We left a heavier spring in the front. We were originally talking about going down to a 1500.
Yeah.
And it wasn't nowhere near enough.
Yeah.
So we did leave the 2500 full springs in it, and it's still, it's a real cushiony ride. They don't feel like a 2500.
Yeah.
When you ride in it.
So one of the cool things about, you know, grain trucks, fire trucks, older vehicles like that with the high up in the C series, they didn't get miled up like the half tons, right?
No.
So the sheet metal in this thing is super nice.
It had 5 spots that I had to fix, and they were all about the size of a quarter, except
yeah,
the driver rocker panel.
Yeah.
And I replaced the very bottom end, about 2 inches of the A-pillar,
yeah,
and then the rocker panel, and that was it.
Yeah.
The truck was really clean for what it was.
Yeah.
For the year of it.
And your dad's truck right there. I mean, that thing is super clean too. But we were just talking about it before we fired the camera up. And one of the cool things that we get to see, and he said you were actually a little bit reticent of bringing it down here unfinished.
I was.
But I argue that because we're never gonna get a glimpse into the bones of this truck like this. This shows what you're doing to it. It shows your direction, the quality of workmanship, and the quality of the metal. So I want to say congratulations for bringing this thing here. For sure, for sure.
No, it was, when you're sitting next to that.
Yeah.
He's like,
yeah.
What happened? We had gone to a car show in Bethalto, Illinois, because it was like 2.5 miles from the house.
Yeah.
And he taught me into driving the back roads and getting it there. And as soon as we showed up with this, I mean, it was nonstop all day long. The
yep,
truck was surrounded.
Yep.
People loved it. It's different. And him and all the old, his motorhead buddies, they kind of took a boat and they were like, well, we're going to the C10s with it. And I said, I'm not towing that down there.
Yeah, yeah.
And I lost. I was outnumbered 7-1, and oh, here it sits.
Yeah,
I was
yeah,
like, but I was still very apprehensive about bringing it. One, I was getting it on a trailer. We have to take off the running boards, the front bottom of the fender, and
right,
then we have to put really narrow tires on it to get it to even fit on the trailer.
Heard.
And I was worried about if we hit a big bump on the highway, I was like, I don't want to bend nothing.
Because yeah,
this is, it's taken 2 years to get it here, and I don't need any more setbacks.
Yeah. Well, again, thank you for bringing it down here. So tell me a little bit more, if you don't mind sharing a bit of your story with us. So I know you're a service member. Thank you so much for your sacrifice and your service. And you do some public speaking for...
Different companies have me
yeah,
come out. I served in Iraq and Afghanistan. I was infantry, started out in the infantry, and mm-hmm, I worked as a sniper. And then I started doing personal security details for VIPs, Congress, senators.
Yeah.
I've done some work for a couple of the presidents and
yeah,
working security operations for them. I've got 680 combat missions under my belt. So my last yeah, go-around, I got hit 3 days in a row, and when I got back, they said my luck was running out, and they retired me.
Right,
and
right.
Now I own a company that we do inspections on commercial and industrial sites, buildings, roofs, things
yeah,
like that. So I stay busy with that, and then my pastime is building this.
Yeah, yeah.
A normal person, pretty much. I do a lot of public speaking.
Yeah. Well, I like the fact that you get your hands dirty on this truck. But, you know, one of the things that really resonated with me yesterday is the pride that you spoke about when you talked about your kids doing projects on this truck. And it was just a magical thing. You were talking, I could see you light up. You just beamed up, and you were just so proud of your kids and the work that they've been doing on it. They initiated themselves. So I also want to say thank you for that, because it's our responsibility, yes, as guys that are getting a little bit longer in the tooth to bring enthusiasts into this industry. And it sounds like you're doing that with your kids. So well done, man.
I appreciate it. Well, that was one of them things where I had to be in Dallas-Fort Worth for a couple of days, and the boys knew I didn't want to go with a wooden bed. I wanted a metal bed.
Yeah.
And when we were going to have to build it. So my 14-year-old son, he got out there. I had a 95 long wheelbase, and he trimmed it out perfect. He cut out all the rosette welds, trimmed off everything, got it real nice and clean, and put it in there. And then my 15-year-old, he went in and actually squared everything up with my 14-year-old, and they ordered the panels. They got 4 panels for $40, the additions.
Yeah.
And they cut them and welded them up. And when I got back, I was down there looking at the truck, and they were standing just outside, and yeah, they were nervous. They were like, "Dad, you know, I was like, this is new. What happened? Uh-huh. Why'd y'all touch my truck?" but I wasn't mad at them. I was like, they weld better than I weld. And
yeah.
To know they did that, and they were like, "We just wanted you to like it," but they were so scared I was going to get mad at them.
Oh, man.
And I'm sitting there getting choked up. I was like, no, you boys did a great job, boys.
Yeah, yeah. Well, my background's paint and body, and I looked at the welds, a little bit of finesse, and this thing's paint ready. Yep. So they did a good job, man.
They really did. I'm proud of my boys. Anytime I need help on the truck, they've helped me take this bed on and off.
The 150 times, yeah, it's what it takes.
They helped me line these up. Whenever I had to take the front clip apart, them boys was in. They were 13 and 14 then. And they don't mind getting out there and putting their hands in it. They helped me to rebuild all 4 brakes all the way around.
Yeah.
My youngest boy helped me do all the, it's all stainless steel brake lines in there, and he helped me flare them and bend them. And my sons are my pride and joy. Of course, that's why I like building this. I'm getting to do it with my kids.
Yep.
I help Pop build his, and then he's helping me build mine. It's a family affair.
That's perfect.
It makes you proud as a dad.
Yeah, no doubt. So one of the things that we do when we come to events like this is we walk around, and we look at vehicles, we talk to people, and if something resonates with us, somebody's got a cool story, and the thing is outstanding and just grabs our attention, I'm going to put you on the spot a little bit. We hand out some awards. We call it the AMD 3 Awards. So we're going to present you with the AMD 3 trophy because the vehicle's outstanding. If you weren't here, we weren't talking about it, we would still be talking about this. We'd put it on our socials. But getting to meet you and the love that you have for family and the whole hobby, coupled with your incredible service record, I just want to say thank you for what you're doing, and I want to present you with not only a great swag pack, but you're the proud recipient of the C10 Nationals AMD 3
Oh, well, thank you
Award.
Very much.
You're welcome.
And it's an honor. I've been following you since I was getting high to a grasshopper.
Awesome, man. Thank you.
Few guys my dad and uncle loved to watch on air, and you were one of them. They followed a lot of your little TV show. I say little. I shouldn't say that. That's not little. It's huge. But for me, I was a little kid, I guess.
Yeah, for sure. Well, it was a privilege to be a part of that, and thanks for making that connection, too, man.
Well, I'm telling you, I'm getting ready. You're talking about getting ready to do paint.
Yeah.
And I'm on your channel all the time watching you mix and kind of wondering how I'm going to paint it. And I've never painted a truck before, so for me, I'm pretty nervous about it. I don't want to spend a whole bunch of money and do it multiple times.
I'll tell you like I tell everybody else. You can do it 3 times and get it right on the 4th time and still be cheaper than taking it to a shop.
Yes, sir.
So let me help you. Let me walk you through that with Paintucation, right?
Oh, yes, sir.
Okay. Congratulations on the AMD 3. Congratulations on a truck build that is outstanding. I cannot wait to see this thing finished out, dude.
Me and you both. I'm getting tired. I want to enjoy the ride now.
That's fantastic. How can people find you on the socials and follow this build?
I'm on the, if you go on Facebook, one of the things I post on all the time is C50, 60, and 70 fan page.
Yeah.
And then if you go to my Facebook, everything on there is personal that I post about the trucks.
Right.
I have nothing to hide.
Yeah. I got a feeling people are going to be clamoring onto this thing and following
it. I hope so. I haven't seen one like it yet. It's the only one I've seen where we've, on this one, the 60 to 66. The 70 to 7, or 67 to 72s, I've seen 4 others that are like Pops, but they're the 4 that actually drop the fenders down and it doesn't look skinny in the back.
Yeah.
Not knocking anybody. Everybody's got their own flavor.
No, everybody's got their own flavor. Yeah, for
sure. This one right here, I was looking for something. I wanted it to look beefy. I wanted it to look muscled up, kind of
Mission accomplished, dude. Absolutely.
Kind of like a pit bull.
Perfect. A C-Series pit bull. I love it. I love it. Bucket list stuff right here. This is wild. The hair is standing up on my arms right now.
You can step on the floorboard.
Okay. I didn't know. Okay, so I'm altitude challenged. No, I can reach.
You can actually adjust the seat. It's right up underneath.
Yeah, it's pretty good right here, though.
Oh, perfect.
Actually, all right.
You're going to need the keys.
Jarvis. This is so clean inside here. The metal is in such great shape. Thank you.
There was a little bit right above your head right here.
Right.
And I welded it in and fixed it. It was maybe the size of a pencil, but I just shaved. I didn't even cut it out. I used a grinder to just go across and then put a little piece in there. And can't even tell it was done now.
Nope.
But yeah, she's...
So lights right up. And this is a Dakota setup?
Yeah, so that's digital Dakota. That's the RTX gauges.
Yeah.
I like it because I can pull it up on my phone and actually monitor everything going on.
Yeah, for sure. And do all your presets on the app. Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Very cool. Typical detents.
Still working on. Go down one more.
One more.
There you go. There you go.
All right. I'll try not to.
Oh, no, we're good. If we go underneath the tunnel, we can actually go underneath the tunnel and turn right, and we got that huge road back here.
Okay.
But for what it is, and only having a basic tune, it's actually first gear shifting from first to second. It's got a little bit of a hard shift.
Yeah.
Empty bag.
I didn't know they were.
I would
want to
go around.
I
recording, you handed it to me.
You dork.
At least no one got it.